Hey everyone, Brian Elliott with Focused Story Films here, and today I'm going to be talking about the Voigtlander 42.5 f0.95 lens. This is a fantastic lens. It is nice and heavy for a Micro Four Thirds lens. This, as I mentioned, is a Micro Four Thirds lens. Do not get this for your APS-C or full frame camera. You will be crushed because it has a Micro Four Thirds lens mount. We are closed all the way down to f16, open it all the way up. That's nice and bright, getting a ton of light in here. It does get a little bit less sharp when you get to f1.5, f0.95, so do be aware of that. I don't think it's detrimental. I've used it at f0.95 and f1.5 quite frequently at weddings to get some really nice shallow depth of field, or when it gets dark and I want to be letting more light in. The characteristics of this lens really lend itself to some more artistic shooting because it's a less clinical lens. It has a really interesting bokeh pattern that I really enjoy. All of the Voigtlander lenses do. I really like the 85 millimeter equivalent kind of length. I've shot entire projects on this lens, more like outdoor projects where I was able to be far enough back, but you get a nice creaminess to the skin tones, nice creaminess to the background. Things just look really, really nice. You get some nice interesting flares on this lens. I really like how it flares. Some people hate flares on lenses. I generally embrace them for the most part. It doesn't tend to wash out too badly unless you're like really blasting a light in there. But you can judge for yourself with all of the B-roll that I'm showing. I enjoy the weight of this lens because Micro Four Thirds tends to be such light systems. This lens is great to kind of weight it up. Like here I've got my ancient GH3. This probably weighs two or three times as much as the GH3, so you actually add some weight and heft. The GH5 is definitely heavier than the GH3, but you add this guy on, and you have a nice weightier body, which helps with stabilization. This is a totally manual lens, so don't expect any stabilization from the lens. You can still get it in the body by setting the focal length manually. If you're using like the GH5, for example, or a lot of Panasonic cameras that have the stabilization, but if you're using it on something like the Blackmagic Pocket 4K, you're not gonna have any stabilization with this lens. Or if you're using an old camera like the GH3 here that I've got, for example, you are not going to be getting any kind of stabilization, so be aware of that. As far as chromatic aberration, I have not found it to be incredibly bad. Obviously, you know, as you get up to f1.5, 0.95, you're going to see more of it than when you stop down. For the most part, I shoot this lens at f2.8, f2, f4, because that you can generally get enough in focus. But if I'm wanting to do something really artsy, this is great to shoot, to be able to go all the way down, since Micro Four Thirds has about half the shallow depth of field that you would get on a full frame camera like I'm shooting on right now. Basically, with this guy, you're able to get almost like a f2 on a full frame camera, which is really, really nice, and on an 85 millimeter equivalent. You don't really want more than that, to be honest. Like, I would not want to be able to go much shallower because you can't keep a diddly in focus at that. So that's really all I got to say about this lens, but I really like this lens. I've used this lens quite a bit. It's in great condition. I am selling this lens because I'm not shooting a ton of Micro Four Thirds now, but if you are in the Micro Four Thirds market, I would recommend nothing higher than the Voigtlander line. I love the look that you get out of these lenses. It has a very special quality to it that's hard to quite put your finger on, but I definitely love this lens and enjoyed working with the other Voigtlanders the few times that I've been able to work with them. So I hope that you guys found this helpful, and I will catch all of you in the next video.